In the very beginning, the primitive human used stones as tools, and this led to the start of the Stone Age. Man then discovered ores and developed metallurgical technology. The human civilization then turned into the Bronze Age. Afterwards, cast iron appeared, leading to the Steel Age. This is the period of time when people started to use iron until the mid-19th century.
Yes, the soil under our feet supplies the raw material of the tools that the manpower relies on, such as stone, bronze, and steel. This is our core material.
Everybody could have a cell phone. Inside this cell phone, you have a very important component. It is a ceramic piece that is made of material and very high technology. We know in the past, there's a lot of cars, vehicles, trucks on the way, and they use gasoline to drive the car. But nowadays, people are moving toward electric cars or hybrid electric cars. In order to drive this type of car, you need two major components. One is battery, one is capacitor. Both are energy storage. The material scientist has a lot to do with developing this type of technology.
Different materials can be synthesized with properties that are completely different from their original nature. It's actually a very interesting process.
We sometimes joke that the process of anodizing material is just like building Lego models. And the final product can be a very cool gum pen or just a sheet of plastic wrap being used in a kitchen.
Professor, do you think I can make an Iron Man's nano armor?
Sure, why not? You can make the most of imagination. We'll navigate your way to success.
The program of material science covers courses and topics like crystalline structure and phase transformation, microstructure characterization, material processing, electrochemistry, kinetics and thermodynamics, polymer properties, and experimental training, etc. Here at GTIT, students can enter the teaching laboratory, research laboratory, or participating in professors' research projects in the early stage of their college lives. Through hands-on practice, they can make their own Iron Man mark or an energy storage device for an electric car or other sensors.
As a GTIT student, whether you would like to apply for graduate studies, join an academic institution, or pursue further studies overseas, like the USA or Europe, you have more competitive advantages than others.
Students who are interested in pursuing graduate study or doctoral programs can choose the research fields like energy materials, nanoelectronics, metallurgy, and functional nanomaterials. We are happy to work with you to explore the future of energy technology and to discuss the feasibility of executing an arc reactor.
If you are passionate about technology,
if you have curiosity for the world,
if you are excited about the unknown,
and if you are ready to move forward